Hey there folks, Paul Markle with Student of the Gun here, and I have a public service announcement for you guys today. Today we're going to talk about how to load an AR-15 magazine using single rounds, and 10 round stripper clips. Now, when you've been doing something for as long as I have, or maybe you've been doing something for a long, long time, it's easy to assume that everybody else already gets it, everybody else already understands, and you don't need to talk about it, you don't need to explain it, because surely by now, everybody knows. I've been loading these magazines, AR-15 style aluminum magazines, for better than 30 years now, going on 35 years or so. And you would assume that everybody understands how they work. Now, the first thing I want to address is loading a rifle magazine is different than loading a pistol magazine. You say, what do you mean? You just stuff the bullets in. I have watched people try to load an AR-15 magazine like you would a pistol magazine by pushing the rounds like this and sliding them back. You say, well, what's wrong with that, Paul? Isn't that how you load? That's how I load my Glock mag. That's how I load an AR-15 mag, right? No. Just put the round on top, push it down, put the round on top, push it down, put it on top, push it down, put it on top, push it down. Boom, boom, boom. See how fast that was? If you've been trying to load AR-15 magazines like pistol magazines, if you do it like that, wow, epiphanous moment. That's kind of crazy. Now, recently, I talked to somebody who is of my age, and they said that they hated stripper clips, that they were the bane of their existence, and that they wish people wouldn't sell ammunition on stripper clips. Well, let me tell you what. This is a clip, a stripper clip, that holds 10 rounds of ammunition together. Why do these exist? These exist because in the United States military, or in any military, really, they figured out a long, long time ago that the best way to keep ammunition secure and together is to put it on these little clippy things, right? So if I was in the field and I said, hey man, give me some ammo, I could grab a couple of these, toss them to you, hand them to you, and it would be a lot easier for me to hand you two of these than scoop up 20 loose rounds. So in the military, they design these so that you don't have a bunch of loose rounds laying around, which is a good thing. Now, but how does that help us load our magazines more quickly? Well, we've got standard aluminum G.I. Joe mil-spec here, mil-spec magazine. And then I have a brand new, in the bag, Gen 3 P-Mag. This is a P-Mag Gen 3. It's got a gray follower. It's a gray non-tilt follower, and so on and so forth. A lot of guys like these. The Marine Corps loves these. You may have noticed on your P-Mags, on your AR-15 P-Mags, that there's these little slots right there. See that? There's identical slots, and you may have wondered to yourself, or maybe you don't pay that much attention, but maybe you wondered to yourself, why are those little slots there? That seems weird to me. Why would that be there? Those little slots are there so that you can take, so this is a stripper clip. This is a clip of ammunition. This little device right here, sometimes it's referred to as a spoon because it kind of looks like a spoon, but this is a G.I. Joe, USMC, well, U.S. Army, whatever, speed loader, right? So you need these both to work together. So this is how it works. And if you've got a green bandolier full of ammo like this, there's probably going to be at least one inside of there, all right? These come, if someone sold you ammunition on stripper clips, one of these should be in the package. So you stick it on the back, right, like so, and you slide it down, all right? See that? Now, people do all kinds of weird, stupid, crazy things with these stripper clips. You take this, you shove it down here, and you say, oh, now I'm going to take the table and I'm going to ram it. No, because every time you ram this against something, you're damaging the feed lips. The best way to do it, put that on there, put this on here, hold it against your chest, and just push back. Boom. I just put 10 in there, and now I could put 20 or so forth. aluminum magazines, it's the same thing. Slips right over the back like here. G.I. Joe mag. Ah! This one's tight because it's brand new. All right, there we go. There we go. There, that's sticking on there. Put this in here. Hold it against your chest. There we go. Boom, I just put 10 rounds in there. And then I could put 20 and 30. So look how fast that was. So stripper clips are not dumb. They're not annoying. They're not silly. They're there for a reason, but you need to have the spoon to make them work right. If you don't have the little loader, and if you just have rounds like this, you're not gonna be able to load your magazines quick. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Number one, you don't need to load a rifle magazine like a pistol by putting the rounds out and sliding it back. Just put them in the top, 1, 2, 3, 4. And also, if you bought ammo, if you got a can ammo or surplus ammo or whatever with these, there's nothing wrong with them. And of course, you can reload the or reuse these until the little tabs break if you wanted. So I save these, throw them in a can, and use them later. And then, of course, you need your spoon, your little speed loader. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is how to load an AR-15 magazine. I hope you enjoyed it. I am Paul Markle with Student of the Gun. And remember, you're a beginner once, a student for life.